Growth of graphene in tube furnace. Here we will discuss CVD method on growing graphene and the tube furnace. So actually, first of all, what graphene is? It's an allotrope of carbon that consists of single layer of atom that are basically arranged in this honeycomb lattice, and it's a 2D layer of carbon atom with sp2 hybridization. Basically, the graphene is extracted through graphite, that is bulk material, and it is 3D. And in the graphite, these graphene layers are basically held by very weak van der Waals forces. But here in graphene, these carbon atoms are basically covalently bonding, and so they are very strong. Graphene is really thinnest compound known to the human being. It's could be at one atomic thick and having very high strength. Despite the fact that it's 2D, but still its stability is very high and its yield strength is very high. If we talk about the history of graphene, then it was Andrew Tim and Kostia Novels that in University of Manchester in 2004, they extracted the single layer of graphene through graphite by using the scotch tape method for obtaining the one atomic layer of the carbon graphite. They basically further worked in the field of graphene, and they received the Nobel Prize in Physics for their achievement in the graphene in 2010. Basically, graphene's unique combination of extraordinary properties affect a fascinating material platform to the development of next-generation technology in many fields. It has very good physical, electronic, and mechanical properties that are originated from 2D electron confinement. So graphene is transparent and having a lot of further advantages. So graphene, we can use the different method to develop or prepare the graphene, but the most best method is the chemical vapor deposition method. If you want to grow graphene in a very pure form, so this CVD method is inexpensive, and you can grow very high quality graphene that is best at the industrial scale. In this slide, we will discuss about the growth mechanism of graphene in CVD. There are 8 steps through which you can describe the whole growth mechanism. The first one is the mass transport of the reactant. In this step, the different reactor gases are basically entered to the chamber. The second one is the film precursor reactor. Here the different gases basically react with each other. Then the third step is diffusion of gas molecule. In this step, different gases are basically diffused into each other. And the next fourth one is the adsorption of precursor. In this step, there is the adhesion of the atoms that are actually submitted from their gaseous state to the onto the solid surface. The fifth one is the precursor diffusion into the substrate. Now these precursors are the source of carbon, are basically diffused into the solid substrate. The next step is the surface reaction. When they diffuse into the substrate, then the surface starts reaction with these particles. Then after that, there is a desorption of byproducts. As you know that here, let me tell you one thing, that here you use hydrocarbons as a source of carbons, though, so we just simply required here the carbon. The other hydrogen or any other gases that are simply entered into the reactor chamber, that are not desirable. That's why they are taken out of the chamber through different gases, these are basically byproducts known as byproduct, and these are desorbed through this substrate surface. Then after that, the 8th step is the removal of the byproducts through the chamber, that is going through the exhaust wall out of the chamber. This is the next slide. In this slide, we will discuss about the construction and working of for the growth of graphene in tube furnace experiment. First of all, this is a tube furnace that is made up of quartz, fused quartz, that is silicon oxide. It's having very high melting temperature, so its workability is very efficient. That's why we are using here quartz. It's also transparent, so you can also watch the material that is basically keep inside the in this tube furnace. So basically the tube furnace is an electrical heating device that is used to conduct different procedure like purification and synthesis process. So here you are using to synthesize the graphene in this tube furnace. So it actually consists of a cylindrical cavity that is surrounded by heating coils and that are embedded so that the temperature can be controlled by using thermocouple. So fused silica is basically a glass that is consist of silica and amorphous crystalline, and it's a very high melting temperature, so it's we are using here so that it might not react with the other reactant gases, as well as it should withstand with the high temperature that is used in the tube furnace. Here you are using any source of gas, nitrogen, argon, or also H2 for hydrogenation, as well as you are entering through here hydrocarbon that is made up of hydrogen or carbon, and you are controlling this through mass flow controls, and the mixing gas mixing unit is present here such that it basically mixes the different gases at according to the required ratio before they are going to enter into the chamber. So this is the quartz tube you can see here. This is the thermocouple to measure the temperature, and this is the all these data operators basically kept in the tube furnace. Here you can keep the sample or substrate here on to which you are going to deposit the graphene. Through this temperature controller you can control the temperature of tube furnace. So here you are using as a copper as a substrate, because copper is inexpensive, as well as there is low solubility of copper, copper into carbon or carbon to copper. That's why we are using the copper. That is best to choose here as a substrate of for the growth of graphene. Here the hydrocarbon gases that are used as a source of carbon are methane, that is CH4, or acetylene, that is C2H2, or any other hydrocarbon that could be ethanol or anything else. The graphene basically grows in the tube furnace at the temperature 650 up to 1100 degrees Celsius. And basically what phenomena happen here at high temperature, the hydrocarbon that is made up of hydrogen and carbon is decomposed into the carbon and hydrogen. The carbon is deposited onto the substrate as a graphene layer, and the hydrogen is basically taken out of the chamber as a byproduct. So here follow this equation, CH4, it's decomposed and made up, made like hydrogen in gaseous form, that is act as a byproduct, and the carbon is deposited onto the substrate in solid form. So here is an animated video in which you can see that how actually graphene grow. This is the copper substrate. Now this is kept inside in vacuum chamber, inside the chamber. Now methane is entered and you are just simply heating up at very high temperature. Now when you are simply heating, then there is a decomposition of the carbon atom. Carbon atoms are basically surrounded by four hydrogen atoms. So at high temperature they are decomposed, and they are decomposed into the hydrogen and carbon separately. So the carbon atom are basically deposited onto this is the copper substrate. They are deposited here where these small hydrogen atoms are act as a byproduct, and they are taken out of the chamber. I have also mentioned about the nitrogen or inert gas like argon. Basically the purpose of using nitrogen or argon gas is we simply want to take the byproducts out of the chamber. So argon and nitrogen basically help us to do this. And another gas that we entered in the chamber with the hydrocarbon, that is the hydrogen. So basically we are simply annealing the sample in the presence of sample, so that the sample look very neat and clean without any defects. When we grow graphene in the tube furnace, then CVD is the, we know that it's an efficient, very best method to grow the graphene, but it have many challenges for the manufacturer. When we simply grow graphene in the tube furnace that are made up of quartz, then their crystalline quality were excellent, but the sample was having very small contaminated particles that were very white dot-like contamination. These images were seen in the scanning electron microscope, in which graphene was grow either at low pressure or atmospheric pressure, but these dot-like contamination were sitting onto the top of the graphene. These were round particles with having a few nanometer height through different microscopy. So these contaminants were actually found either at low or atmospheric pressure, and regardless of the carbon precursor, either you are using ethanol, acetylene, or any other hydrocarbon, and either you are growing this at copper substrate or aluminum or any other substrate, these particles were found whenever you just simply use the quartz tube furnace. So further, scientists studied about this, and they found that these particles are basically contaminants or of silicon oxide. Experiment to find out the reason behind these contaminated particles. So they deduced further results about from their experiments that almost no contamination was found in sample of graphene that were grown in tube furnace that is made up of quartz, and it was new mean and the heavy contamination was found in aged tube furnace, and heavy contamination could be found if you are growing graphene for the time period longer than 30 minutes. They said that there is a possibility that the quartz tube is actually experiencing many impurities during CVD process. There is a possibility of phase transition in quartz tube as we are increasing the temperature, and for the silicon oxide, the phase transition actually start at 570 degrees Celsius. So there is the possibility of the phase transition of the quartz tube. That's why the further silicon oxide particles are actually emitted from the quartz tube, and they are simply deposited onto the layer. Decreased when we are increasing the temperature. So this density fluctuation are basically responsible for the diffusion of copper into the bulk of quartz tube. So silicon oxide is displaced and emitted and deposited onto the graphene. So that could be the reason for their contamination. So they did another experiment by using the instead of quartz tube, they used alumina tube, that is aluminum oxide, and further article was published in journal Scientific Reports in August 2017, and the research basically revealed that by adding alumina tube coaxial to the tube furnace as a screen for copper, there were no contamination problem. So alumina have basically higher thermochemical stability, and its melting temperature is also higher than quartz tube, so it's best to use, but it's not transparent like tube furnace that is made up of quartz. So by using alumina screen, we can avoid contamination problem, and it can improve the CVD for graphene growth for industrial scale purpose. But one of the drawback is that make sure that you should not that alumina board is basically must not expose to air while it's hot, unlike tube furnace. So here we have conclusion. In the future, basically, it is dire need to develop more efficient and low-cost CVD system for the effective quality of graphene. As I have already told you that graphene have very best electrical, thermal, and so that's why it's a dire need of graphene. It's the thinnest material, so this could also be used in the electrode and photovoltaic materials that are used as charge holder, and the graphene is very flexible as well as transparent, so sun basically knock out many electrons easily when you are simply using it as a solar panel. So the rolling sheet of basically graphene can also be used and it act as a carbon nanotube. Here you can see that when you are simply rolling the graphene sheet, then it becomes a carbon nanotube. These carbon nanotubes are very light in weight and they are having very effective strength, that is 300 times more than steel. So they can also be used as a bulletproof vests. As very lightweight, so it's easy to carry. And the further advancement in manufacture of this material, we will be able to perform the to better the performance of nano devices, as well as this the most appropriate method for the sensor of graphene is basically chemical vapor deposition method. So it's very much desirable for us to maintain the purity and quality of the graphene that should be used at the industrial scale purpose. Thank you.